Monster is dragon type on Supreme Deck to graveyard. The reason you want to do this is usually to send the white zone of ancients, or to get both of your blue eyes in there, because usually it's easier to get your blue eyes out once it's in the graveyard. That's the whole idea behind these puppies. And then I run 2 Silver's Cry, and you get 2 normal summon, or sorry, special summon, 1 dragon type normal monster from your graveyard. So I run 2 of these. Is send one monster from your hand to the graveyard, special summon one level 1 monster from your hand or deck. So let's say you have a blue eyes in your hand, you need it in the graveyard. It's good to get rid of that. You can add one of the tuners into your hand and, you know, kind of get the ball rolling from there. That's why I have this. Then I have an enemy controller. This is just good as defense as well, to just get if a monster's attacking. When you control a level 7 or higher normal monster, when a monster would be summoned or a spell or trap card is activated, negate the summon or activation, and if you do, destroy that card. Sorry, my hair is joining the party. Then I run a magical cylinder, which just deflects the damage that's coming at you back towards your opponent, and negates attack against you. And then I run a shadow spell, which to 700 attack and ignore attack or change its battle position. And if this card is destroyed, if the monster it's equipped to is destroyed, this card gets removed from the field, the graveyard. I have a lot of defensive cards in this deck. I don't know why. It's kind of overloaded with it almost, but because then I have a Kunai with Chain. I think this is like old art or something. I'm not 100% sure though. Activate. Monster declares an attack. Target the attacking monster, change the target to defense position, and then you equip this to one of your monsters, and it gains 500 attack. And the last trap I run is Spellbinding Circle. Basically, the monster can't attack or change its battle position when it's equipped with this. Again, I have a lot of counters. So, that was everything. I'll show you some cards I can. Another good card is Call of the Haunted, so you just bring back a monster from the graveyard, basically, and this card's equipped to it. We have Wapoku, which, this is an old card, so it actually has the wrong text on it now, so never mind, we'll put that away, I realize. I found another mystical space type, and I'll keep that. Another good one. We have regular Mirror Force, which when an opponent destroy all attack position monsters your opponent controls. That's crazy. I found another enemy controller. We got Fiendish Chain, so it can only target effect monsters though. Its effects are negated. Also, it can only attack when it's destroyed. Destroy this card. So that's another good card. Then we have a Storming Mirror Force. When an opponent's monster declares an attack, return all your opponent's attack position monsters to the hand. The other Mirror Force is Drowning Mirror Force, but that has to be a direct attack, and then it goes back into the monsters go back into the deck. So I have some cards down here. I'm just kind of sorting through as well. Another thing I considered was a Quantum. It's got the shatter effect. I like that as well. It's basically just a token with 2200 defense. So. This is the right to Wapoku. So, you take no battle damage from your opponent's monsters this turn. Your monsters cannot be destroyed by battle this turn. And the old art, or the old one, just says, any damage inflicted by opponent's monster is decreased to zero, but doesn't say anything about the monster's being saved, so it's kind of bad. This is actually from a